Okay. We're recording. All right. Okay, I've got another stoned observation on what it is to be a human being. And maybe someday I'll have to talk about why I'm stoned. I mean, I could do this straight, but it's not as much fun. So, I ended the first one I did on being human. It ended with the idea that seeing the complexity of what goes on in your brain. I mean, you can't see it in detail, but to get a glimpse of how complex it is, and that is making you right now. I mean, it's making your perception of you. I mean, it doesn't make you out of, you know, atoms or anything. But it's making your perception of what it is to be you right now is being made by these neurons in your brain. Me too. We're all in the same boat, you know. So this change in perspective, seeing that complexity, the change in perspective that can give you, you realize that there's no way that you can possibly be in control of that. And that really your brain is making you. It's making the whole thing. It's making this whole sense of me being me sitting here talking. So when you understand how totally fucking mind-boggling, I wish I could think of another adjective, but it is. Anyway, the point is, it changes you realize. Well, I realize, and some of us realize, that we're just in this organism. We are this organism. And it has evolved over millions of years to be exactly what it is right now. Lisa Feldman Barrett. Too many names, Lisa. She talks about the brain, the way the brain is organized, the way that it's evolved to be, is that it creates a mind. Concept, but it creates a mind that fits the environment that it's in. So that means culture, religion, nationality, climate, everything. Whatever brain is born into that environment will build a world based on that environment. So everybody gets built that way. I get built. You think about it. I mean, if that's the way it works from the beginning, that's what, you know, she described. She makes this transition. It's kind of shaky, you know, so I would say. So as a baby, your brain is just trying to make sense of the world. And your caregivers are providing you with the world. And a world that is part of the larger environment that you will fit into when you're mature, right? And that goes on. Your brain is just absorbing this information. It's being incorporated into its idea of who you are. It's all just a matter of your brain adapting to this environment, right? So everything that happens around you ever since you were born is going into your brain and becoming a part of how it sees the world and how it sees itself in you, right? So I say that's my blogging. Let me tell you, the first time I got a glimpse of it, and it wasn't exactly through that idea of complexity, it was another, a long trip ago, I got a glimpse of what it was to be an organism ensconced on a planet in this environment, right? And it was scary as shit. I mean, I remember clearly two episodes where, you know, I don't know exactly where I was, and I don't know what triggered it, but just the realization was, this is all real. It's that there is a, that doesn't sound very profound, does it? But that, really, that what's real is being ensconced in this reality, being a member of this organism that is society. So that, to realize then that I really am just along for the ride. My brain is doing all this work behind the scenes, and I have the illusion that you know, my brain is doing it, but I have no fucking idea how. So it's not like I'm in control of the process. It just flows, you know? And that's how life is. But so as I say, the first couple of times I realized that it was really scary. And it got a little more intellectual, as I understood what it was that I was experiencing, let's see what happened then. I began to see more in my everyday life how everything I did fit into this program that I was just born into, and it's just playing out, right? And so I became more aware of that, and I became more aware that really everybody's in the same boat, you know? We're all just doing, you know, going along with this program. And when I see that, understanding that, it's like you're looking behind the curtain, and you see it's this little guy, Wizard of Oz, right? And so. Oh, I am so high. It's, well, let's see. So the change that happens is seeing that we're all in the same boat, and seeing how there is no way that you can really blame anyone. I mean, we all have to take responsibility for the society to work. You know, everybody's got to do their little job and everything. But But we're just cogs in the machine. I mean, I don't mean that in a metaphorical sense. Well, I guess it is real. We're not really cogs, but we're just part of this huge network. And so seeing that and seeing how it's all put together, seeing how I was put together, really, I can start seeing, well, I got this piece from here, and I got that piece from there, and this piece from another place. And I'm thinking, this is something, a good thing Lisa said, this is what happened to me in effect, was that the more categories you have to put your experience in, or the way I would put it, or maybe she put it somewhere else, I don't know, is that the more material that your brain has to work with to solve this puzzle of where we are and what's happening, the more tools it'll have in its toolbox, right? The more ways it will have of looking at situations and understanding them. So I got a minor in anthropology in college, and it was a huge eye-opener and a part of my development, right, is to see how people in different cultures live. This is what we studied here. And to realize the variety in human behavior and values and beliefs, is, and you realize how plastic it all is. Just brains developing in their environment. And this is what happens. So, the thing that makes it enjoyable to me is to see that we're just all in this. Just being propelled along by what we're exposed to. You're being exposed to me. And you better be careful, something might just change the wiring in your brain slightly, and you will think differently. That's how it works, right? So to see that we're all in that situation, that we all just, if you're in the same intellectual situation that I am, you wake up one day and you see where we are, that we're just evolved beings on the planet. It's amazing. It's amazing to be such a creature. and to see that you're such a creature, that's the amazing part, is that from this perspective you can see what an amazing thing it is to be a human being, and how totally bizarre it is at the same time. I mean, we live in a made-up world, and not, that doesn't mean it's not real, but people made it up. I mean, it evolved, right? It's not a given thing. If you had been in a different place and all this, you'd be a different person. Your brain would have evolved in a different environment. So we all are in this same predicament of having been born in a particular environment and having adapted to that and trying to figure, given that there are other ways of doing things. How do we behave? And that's where anthropology comes in. And really, just having a broader perspective on the width and breadth of humanity. It's from the past, the way back to when we were all hunters and gatherers. It's amazing. Everybody was. We were all doing the same thing. And now we got to this. And it's just an amazing process. But nobody was in control anywhere along the way. It was just brains adapting to their environment, and their environment changed, and the brain changed, and here we are. So, in that sense, it's just amazingly humorous to be a person, you know, that I am this. It's just an amazing thing. And if you have never glimpsed that, you think I'm a crazy person, and I wouldn't blame you. But I said to a guy one time, "There is a reality, and it will reach up and bite you in the ass if you don't pay attention." and that's what I've been trying to do ever since, or before even. Not my fault, I just fell into that groove, you know. So anyway, I hope something in this has been beneficial, and that you can look at your life with a smile. Okay, I look at mine that way.